Hello, Twitch viewers, Art Town residents, and that's all the type of people that there are. Hi, my name is Reagan Dickard. I am an artist and illustrator, as you can see, in Seattle, Washington. And this is my Wednesday Art Town draw stream. Welcome. I'm just gonna doodle a little bit until I see I have an announcement to make, but I want to see if anybody here hasn't already heard the announcement. So I'm gonna just doodle a little bit until so point that my someone's here that wants to hear the announcement. So if that's you, you can let me know. Let me know or forever hold your peace. Hello everybody, what's up? I just finished drawing a all day. And now I'm gonna draw for another 2 hours, but that's okay because this is fun, chill drawing where I can do whatever I want. which is the whole point of these Wednesday streams. So I've been drawing all day. My arm might get a little tired, but we're not gonna let that happen. We're gonna take little breaks. We're gonna. We're gonna be perfect. Okay, I think this is enough doodling, actually. You know what? I'll let the announcement kind of speak for itself, because I want to start working on the thing that I'm supposed to work on, which is not this silly little whatever this is. a self-portrait, I guess? What does it mean? What? Said I was gonna stop, and then I keep drawing. That's the Reagan way, though. That's just how I do. You'll learn. You'll all learn. Wow. So I'm just gonna say, normally, or historically, I have not been a very like line work type of artist. I've tended to like. Solid color and then very like graphic line work and just not doing outlines has been kind of my style for a while, but lately I've been experimenting with actually using line work, can you believe? And I've been having a pretty fun time. Yeah, I have no idea what this drawing is, but I kind of love it and I identify with it strongly. So this is just, I'd say, the most common thing that comes out when I doodle is this exactly. Just silly little drawings of myself. Okay, that's great. This is good. All right, great sketching. All right, I'm going to work on the thing I actually want to work on. And you can watch if you want. So here's the thing. My partner proposed, now my fiance, budding. So I'm drawing a little announcement. I'm gonna hide this in case any. Anybody hasn't heard yet. I haven't posted on social media, so I'm trying to draw it here. And I'm not exactly sure what style I want. This is the drawing I'm like basing it off of. But I'm trying to arrange it a little differently so that this, I just want to do a drawing version of it so that we are like bigger in the picture and the background is like nicely framed. And I'm not sure if I want to do this kind of a realistic style or not. I'm just gonna keep going with it. I was gonna say I need a mirror, but I guess I can just use this webcam picture of myself to see what my hair looks like from this angle. Okay. Ringlets. She's got ringlets. Okay, they're good. And I always pin it up. I asked Zach, my fiance, this morning how he likes my hair best, and he said, I don't know, down. You don't know my hairstyles. It's just like, to me, my hairstyles all look like vastly different. So I'm like, how can you not know what the hairstyle looks like? But like when I talk to my middle sister, she's always like, your hair always looks the same. I'm like, how does my hair look? She's like, always the same. Never different. And I'm like, it's not true. It looks vastly different. Alright, so like I said with the style, I don't really know what I'm going for. Not sure if I'm liking this, but I'm gonna keep drawing it and then I can adjust it later, you know. None of it doesn't really matter. just feels like a serious announcement. You want kind of a serious art style, maybe, but... So I'm drawing my little ringlets here. Completely stylized. Style. Ringlets. And I'll kind of add a little bit of... Okay, so the ringlets, you want to kind of overlap it like that. Yeah. There. Now it's doing like a little corkscrew motion. Not exactly like that, but actually, yes, exactly like that. That's exactly how you do it. This is such a like a serious drawing compared to how I normally draw, which is something like that. But we're experimenting, you know? Experimenting. Keep looking up here, checking my hairstyle for reference. Frizzy ringlets. Yeah, we'll just finish this up and then do something about these faces. In fact, I think I wanna draw over the face again. Here's my reference of me. Hello. Hello. Put it at the top, and this is what we did last week on this stream. We did actually portrait practice, but that was timed. We did 5-minute portraits, and that was fun and hard for me and I think everybody else, because what I like to do in this stream is invite anybody that's joining me to work on something at the same time. And if you're in need of a prompt, my suggestion this week is to make something for someone you love. Be, you know, your best friend, or your pet, or yourself, or your mom. Mother's Day is coming up, so maybe you could draw a portrait for, you know, your mother or a mother figure. And yeah, that's the prompt today. So I'm drawing this for my sweet Zachary. This is him. To announce this great news. Yeah, I don't know how I feel about this style at all, but I also don't really know what to do about it. Don't know how I'm feeling. We'll just keep going. So, yeah, I really like how Zach's face looks. So I feel like I should keep it up with me. And hope that it'll come together like Zach's face came together. Man, I got a big smile. See the gums. I got a gummy smile. And I want to make sure I'm smiling as big as. Let me turn this down a little bit. As big as Zach is. I want to look real happy. Oh, that's cute. It's coming together. Yeah, that's nice. Aw, very cute. Let's see, this eye needs to get moved over. Yeah, alright, that's capturing it. The mood. Does anybody else find themselves making the same face as the thing that they're drawing, because I always do that. I'm kind of copying an artist that does. I've never represented the gums, but sometimes they're a distinctive part of the face. And Tina B, an artist on Christina B, I believe, Tina B Draws or something on Instagram, did a portrait of me and Zach actually a while ago and did these little gum lines, and I was like, oh, that's a great thing to add. Alright, let's try. Get into the horizontal. Aw, very cute. Yeah, that's how you know when the drawing is working well. Hello, welcome! I'm remembering it this time, Valerie? See, on here you don't have your name in the beginning. Valerie. Did I get right? Close! Good, no, Vanessa? Victoria! Ah, I'm sorry, I'm like literally the worst with names. I've done this every single time. Victoria. Do I say... What did I say? What did I even say at the beginning? I shouldn't even try. No, I should try. I wanna remember everybody's names from their thing. Hello, Victoria. I'm sorry. Valerie. Do I say that every time? I feel like I do. Hi, Victoria. How are you? So happy you're here. You get Vanessa a lot, really. Every time it's terrible. Every time I talk to someone, they tell me their name and I'm like, I'm gonna remember it this time. And it just goes bloop. I'm like, no, you just told me. yeah. I'm great. I think you saw on my, on the Discord, on the Art Town Discord, I got engaged this weekend. Yay. There it is. Yeah. So, I'm feeling great. Thank you! I'm so happy. It was a very special day. He's a very special guy. And yeah, I just wanted to draw something for fun, just because we got some sweet pictures. But I just thought it would be fun to immortalize the moment in a drawing. So I'll show you. Working on, I don't know about the style. Obviously it's different than I often draw. Here is a sketch for underneath, and then we've got a little bit of this, obviously very sketchy background this morning, worked on it this morning, to kind of announce what we got going on. I think it's coming out good. What do you feel like it looks like my style, or does it look super different than I normally draw? what do you got going on? Are you drawing anything? The prompt today, should you so choose, is to draw, make something for someone you love. Hi Kayla, welcome. Welcome back. Oh, I'm drawing a crab. Nice. Are you drawing it for someone you love? Because then it's on prompt. Hi Kayla. My day was very good. Pretty busy. I drew basically the entire day. Because I've got some other projects. It's the time of day that my makeup starts to move down into my eyes, because I'm an oily person. My face starts to all move downwards, so. Listen, anytime I look back on the streams, the morning stream, I'm all like fresh, and then the PM stream, I'm like, what did they call it for a while? Oh yeah, stretching. What did they call it when, what was the trend where you would highlight, you know, and you're supposed to look really glowy or whatever? I don't think that's the style anymore, but ooh. Victoria is drawing a crab. Are you cooking, Kayla, as tradition? Some people come on here, their tradition is to make dinner during the stream, because I guess this is dinner time. What are you drawing a crab in, Victoria? Posca marker? Weren't you working in Posca last week? Aw, oh, thanks for prompting me to stretch, Kayla. This feels great. Posca markers, nice. Oh, I'm excited to see it. Having fun, good. They are so much fun. They're tricky. Oh, now we do the forward stretch. Feels good. No leftovers tonight. Nice, so are you drawing something? Ian's at a work happy hour, wow, like in the regular times. And I also have to stretch my jaw. Because something about how I work extra hurts it. Oh. I wanna go to a work happy hour. Work happy hour for us, I guess, would just get the illustrators in Seattle together, which I've done before. Plus the sketchbook out. Sick. I realize that means if everybody's drawing too, it means they're not in chat as much. So technically this is not conducive to the way Twitch wants us to be. It's the way I want us to be. All making art together and hanging out. This looks nicer. Okay, I'm gonna keep going with this. Yeah, I was, I always talk about, I feel like work for me often is like, either there's absolutely nothing to do, and therefore it's hard to get myself to like, work on anything, because it's like, and just hang out on Instagram or whatever all day. I can, I don't know, do busy work, like stamp my envelopes or something. Or I have a bunch to do and I'm like, but you know, now I know it kind of comes and goes, so it's less, I'm not feeling overwhelmed. I just Gotta do it. Alright. Some of my friends in Portland asked me to do a very fun project. That'd be cool. I'll be releasing this summer. Just some advertising for an event that they do every summer, but I've always admired the art and their group. It's also a fun project. It's a pretty, some pretty nerdy subject matter, which I've been wanting to work in. This is too ringlety. Is my hair that ringlety? No, it's like crazier than that. So let's loosen up a bit. Do it a little faster. What is it? I don't think I guess I can't say the subject matter though. It's for a game jam, for a game group in Portland. Game jam is where game makers or people who are interested in learning about making video games, get together and say, like, we're gonna make a game in a week or a weekend or a day or something, however long, you know, they want to do it. And they do different themes every year, and they do a little, like, advertising banner to advertise for it. And yeah, so I'm doing the little advertising banners. But the themes are a surprise, so come out then. They're so cool. They're so cool. People, I'm like so bad at organizing things, so people who are good at organizing stuff impress me so much. I want to be like that. What time are you at Nordstrom? Oh, great question. Let me check my planner. I think I should have written it down. Why are you gonna come see me? Get a free thing? That would be fun. Okay, let's see. Oh, I just noticed I missed. Wait, no, it's this month. Thought I missed my friend's birthday. Okay, I'll be there from 1 to 5 p.m. At the downtown Nordstrom in Seattle. Yeah. Oh, thanks for reminding me. I was about to like try to make plans with you to go look at dresses or something. maybe on Sunday? We'll talk later. Should I keep going with this line work, or should I try to put some color on this whole thing, see how it's gonna come out? Cause that'll affect the style, huh? My hair is not this nice. Alright, let's try plopping some color in this background. So we can make sure it's working. Alright, I'm gonna pull up a reference of what I'm looking at. Where is it? So many pictures. This one. Gosh, I love it. Wait, not that one. This one. There we go. I don't know why this is my favorite picture. Okay, but we're gonna see if we can capture the colors. I'm not very good at this. capturing like a, a painting like a background with complicated colors. Not my forte. Alright, so we're gonna make that small so it's not distracting. Oh, that's a lovely green. Okay, we're off to a good start. Okay, we're gonna just kind of like paint that in. I hope you guys like the new playlist. I love it very much. Good jazzy vibes. All right, we're gonna paint that in. Very good. And then I think we'll go with a little bit of a. Stick with this. I love that green. I just like wham bam popped upon that. let's see, my classic green maybe. Yeah, let's go a little more. Green, no, that's too neon. That's good. Because part of what I love about this view and why Zach chose it to propose there is the, like, richness of the colors. Let's go a little lighter for this layer. And we'll do like a too bright. Too bright. Then we'll do like a layer. We'll do like stacking layers of color, maybe. And I don't quite know the rule of what you're supposed to do with stacking layers of color, you know? I don't know much about landscapes, just what I can eyeball. You know, it's something like the further, I mean, I know, it's more blue the further things get away. But there's probably other rules that I don't know. That's how you like imply distance, I think. Everything academic about art I know from Zach, who studied comics in school and took all of the classes that, you know, on this type of thing that I didn't take in. Because I was in architecture, and they didn't care what architecture students did. Okay, let's get some blue. It's very blue like this. That's a nice color. And then we'll plop that in here. We've gotta plop it, right? And then even further behind that, we want a, hello, like a gray purple, looks like, let's see, lighter. Yes, we did go to the same school. We, that's where we met, yeah. We met at the Savannah College of Art and Design in our freshman year, but we just met via a mutual friend, our friend Dima from Russia, who's in Vienna right now. He and his family all left for Austria. Safety, you know. And that's more of a blue color. And we met and we kind of hit it off as like friends pretty quickly, and he said we met on the bus, which is cute because we still love the bus, and we were talking about video games excitedly, and then we just kind of stopped talking. I stopped talking to him a little bit. Stopped like texting. We were just texting as friends, and I was like, I've got a boyfriend from high school. And I don't want to, you know... Also, we were talking about video games, and I was like, I don't want to leave this guy on. I don't know that much about video games. Just the game that we happened to talk about. And then the next year, we stumbled upon each other at the computer lab, and I checked in with the same friend, Dima, to see if he was single, and he invited me to come hang out for Zach's birthday, and then we just clicked on so many different opinions on things and like interests, and we have been together ever since. Almost, it'll be 9 years this fall, and so when we get married next year, it'll be 10 years.
Wow.
He's great. Scandalous. What, that I was texting about video games with someone? He's a great person. And yeah, I studied architecture, and he studied sequential arts, which is comics. And in architecture, they don't care if you know how to draw things, but the whole point of sequential is to draw everything. So he knows all the technical things you're supposed to do. And he's taught me along the way. He's good to have as a studio buddy, because I can like look up and be like, how are you supposed to like represent like far distance? And he's like, oh, it gets more blue and more less saturated the further away it gets. And I'm like, thank you. It's like an encyclopedia. So he's great at the like technical art stuff. And character design and other things. These clouds are fun. Okay, but next, if we want to represent, well, maybe I'll just block out where we're gonna be. Hello. Maybe I want to change the color of what I'm wearing, but now I'll just block this out. So I can see what part will be covered up better. Maybe I'll also fill in some of our colors. Dun, dun, dun. And we met at SCAD, and actually this bee is supposed to represent my school, and also I just like bees. And I was thinking, my next plan, this whole arm I want to be representations of places that I've visited or lived and that are important to me, and I want to get a tattoo to represent Seattle and our first apartment together that had a rosemary bush outside, so I want to get a rosemary sprig here, possibly before we get married, but I'm gonna have to make some more money to make that happen, you know? Because, you know, how cute would that be? The memories. Scandalize my grandparents. Tattoos on her arms at her wedding? That's something I think my mom said, she's like, are you gonna have tattoos on your arms when you get married? I'm like, yeah. If I have tattoos on my arm when I get married, then yes. That's a thing, I guess. Okay, I'm glad I'm doing this, because it's good to see the colors with everything. Now, should I do black, or should I do the thing where it's like blue represents the dark colors? And then that's the way my own style can come in. Cute tattoo, I want to get a slug to represent Ian in the Pacific Northwest. Yes! Representational tattoos! Hell yeah. Why Ian? Oh, we joke that he's a slug. Cute. I joke about that with Zach too. I call him that when he won't get out of bed in the morning, which is frequently. That's so cute. Your other tattoos are a shark and something else. This is just kind of a color test. Maybe black. I gotta move this. I keep hitting my mic with my pen. Sorry. Set up my mic. Shark and a willow branch. Very cute. Okay, well the black looks too dark. For both of us. Maybe I will do yellow. Yeah, because often Zach wears these. I mean, I like to wear a lot of dark colors too, but lately especially, I've been going crazy with the colorful colors. And often Zach is wearing all black and I'm wearing a very colorful combo. Like I'm wearing, like right now. So this would represent us well, I feel. Victoria, are you married? And no shame if not. I have just been very curious about marriage and weddings and stuff, and I just want to hear everybody's tale. Yes, marriage club. Right, and you have a kid, right? Or two? A baby? I never planned to. Oh! Interesting. Why didn't you plan to? I was just talking to my mom and she was like, you told us you were never gonna get married. And I was like, I don't think I said that. And she was like, oh. Maybe I'm remembering it wrong. I was like, I think you are. She said, like, you just told me you didn't believe in marriage. And I was like, I don't think I've ever said I don't believe in marriage. But it sounds like something you would hear and think that I said. I have two, a 3-year-old and a 6-month-old. Cute, right? And you're super busy with them, huh? And 2-month-old. Those are chaotic ages combined together. Very busy, yeah. I believe it. Does this look like us? Or do I like the style? Do I like the colors? I do not know. How was your marriage, Victoria? Or your wedding? Not your marriage. How's your marriage? You don't have to answer that. How was your wedding? What was your wedding like? Tell us about your relationships. Who was here this morning that told us about her small wedding? Remember with names? Carly was telling us this morning. She shared pictures in the Discord that she had a micro wedding with like 12 people. Shaped now. No. Not really. You had 20. Oh, also pretty small. This hair color. Let's play with it. Dark blue? Let's play with this. Nothing interesting. Oh, that's the sketch. That's why it's doing that. This is looking horrible, but it's gonna be better. I think. I love the song. Skin tone. Let's just pop a skin tone in there, see how that feels. So there, Kazi. Yellow skin tone compared to me, and I have a pink skin tone. I'm like annoyed at my own drawing. You guys know that feeling? You're like, oh, why are you like this? Zach calls his kissable lips. No kidding. Oh, I hate it. Just keep going, Reagan. Just keep going. Just keep going. I mean, this is not the final. Keep saying it until it does. Process is the process. Just keep saying trust the process. Trust the process. No! Trust the process, trust the process. Oh my god, this is so embarrassing! That's how you have to do, it's gotta be bad before it can be good. And sometimes you have to try things. You gotta be messy experiment before you get to the good looking stuff. Ah! And sometimes you do a bunch of work trying to make something work and it looks horrible and you get rid of it and do something different. Beauty of digital art is the undo button, yes. You know, but you also, you gotta try things, right? Why? Nightmare. Sorry to both me and Zach. That's fine. That's the fun thing about streaming is everybody gets to see you in the in-between stages. All right, well, I hate this color, so I'm just gonna go ahead and turn that off. Absolutely not. I'm gonna just delete it. And then we're gonna just do the hi pumpkin. You here to say hi? Alright guys. You know the deal. Pumpkin's here. Gotta say hello. Hi. Hello. Yep. Here she is. Beautiful. Ah, they say hello, pumpkin. Do not run. Do not run, my feet. Beautiful. Let's get you in a close up. Why? Why, she say? Hello, Geomas. Pumpkin says hello. Get the hell off of me. Okay. So, Pumpkin. Back to the train wreck. Back to the process. Hi, Geomas. How is it going? Coming here from Twitch, Instagram, Patreon, Discord. joining us from. Bye bye. If you don't know me, I am Reagan Dickard. I'm an artist in Seattle. And I stream with my patrons who are called residents. Here today we have Kayla and Victoria. And I'm drawing a picture of me and my fiance. New fiance. We just got engaged. I don't know the language. guys, should I draw my hair up or down for this picture? I feel like it's usually down. Up is very uncommon. But it makes it look kind of casual, you know? That's how it was. We had just gone on a long hike. It's actually in a ponytail. It's long enough to put in a ponytail now. For the first time in forever. What's that fun? I think down looks good. Yeah, I remember when I had no hair. Yeah, man, crazy. Did you know, did we hang out when I had shaved head? Yeah, we did. Down looks good. Okay. Down. We hadn't met in real life yet? That's crazy. What? Sure, I'd grown out when I met you. I shaved it in 2019. Is that right? Maybe? No. 2018? Okay. I moved here. I don't remember. Obviously, it is currently 2019, so. Okay, there. So we'll do that so we can see the line work underneath. And we'll do some kind of. We'll do black. For both browns and black. Unless I decide to put brown in the color palette. Yeah, now that I'm engaged and planning a wedding, I'm actually considering, like, should I keep my hair long or should I cut it short again? I feel like it would be really fun to have my, like, pixie cut again and then have, I'm gonna get a vintage wedding dress. Don't know what era. That's part of why I need your help, Kayla. I gotta go try on a bunch of dresses and scour the city for vintage wedding dresses. And so to have like a, you know, cause they were very like formal for the most part and very like girly. So I feel like it would be fun to have the pixie cut paired with like a vintage outfit, but then I'd have to grow it out again. And I am enjoying being able to put it in a ponytail. Love that idea, right? Just to kind of like balance the feminineness of those like vintage dresses And then I could wear some big, cool earrings, and they would stand out a lot. And possibly, I look good in a pixie cut. I also look good with my hair long, but just some ideas. Yeah, I've been scouring. I am determined to get a vintage dress because I love secondhand. All about secondhand. And I also love vintage style, and I love that they don't cost thousands of dollars. I mean, some of them do, so I've got to call ahead to some places. There's a place in Capitol Hill that sells vintage dresses and just clothes in general called Pretty Parlor, but you have to make an appointment to try on the vintage dresses. And so I want to call and be like, hey, just curious, how much do your vintage dresses cost? Because if they're like $3,000, then I'm like, no thank you, I will go to another store. even though I'm, you know. Oh, it's by your house. Ooh, perfect. Well, I'm gonna make, you know, I'm gonna call and see what their prices are, and then we'll make a appointment there. Just to see. Because like I said, there's like so many different styles. Every decade has like vastly different styles. I know I don't want like a 1990s one. I'm not a fan of the 2000s ones with the like strapless and the like sparkly thing. So I don't know if they'll have that as a vintage dress. I don't know if that counts as vintage yet. And I love the 1930s and 40s ones, but those are now almost 100 years old. And so they're more expensive because if it hasn't torn yet, then it might, right? And, but they're so beautiful. They're so like minimalist, and they've got such cool shapes and like cutouts, and they seem really flattering. Also, I look really good in vintage dresses. Like, I feel like I have a kind of vintage aesthetic, less than like a modern aesthetic in terms of, I don't know. I look really good in like 1950s, 1930s, that kind of stuff. Curly hair, and then where I wear like a red or like a dark lip, I'm like, oh my god, amazing. So those are a possibility. Also, I like the 1970s ones a little bit, but I want to try them on because I might hate it on me. Because in the 1970s, there was a trend of doing like Victorian style, but which is like high neck. Oh, I love sleeves too. Gotta have sleeves. But it's like high neck, and then, you know, lots of like complicated details and like lace and like, you know, Victorian, right? So I don't know. I'm just gonna have to try it on, see how it feels, and I guess also decide like what I want to actually do for the party. Also, guys, thanks for letting me rattle on about this. what I want to do for the party, because that's also going to affect how I can do dress, right? Because if I decide to try to save money by have it be like a shorter daytime party, then that means we probably won't have time for dancing. Which I kind of want to do, but I don't know if I, you know, we'll see how many people we end up wanting to invite. And if we can, like, you know, afford enough food for like a long party that includes dancing and like nighttime and such. Because one of the things I might want to do, I have always fantasized about having a dance party with all of my favorite music and Zach's favorite music. And this might be one of the only times that I get to do that. Okay, looking at this, Zach said my face was too small before, but now I think it's too big. I know my eyes turn down at the edges. Oh, no worries. Thank you. Thank you. No, but not that much. Well, I can use the distance of looking at it up there. It's kind of, it's kind of uncanny valley right now. In that it looks kind of like it's trying to be realistic, but just doesn't and misses, and that makes it creepy. So that's no good. Also, how long is my hair? Yeah, so that's some of my thoughts right now on dresses. So I was gonna say, because if it's a dance party, then I want something a little funkier, probably, right? Because I don't want to feel extremely fancy and, like, you know, I want something I can dance in. If we're gonna be having a dance party, which I think I'm going to want to, but we'll have to see if I can afford it. Or I could get something fancy as long as it's not too expensive, and then get a white suit for dancing in. What? Wouldn't that be fun? A cream suit, maybe? Come on, like. I never thought I would want to do like a two outfit thing. You know, I was always like, why would you need two outfits for your wedding? But. Because dancing, that's why. That's a good reason. Alright, Zach also had like a red design on his shirt. It has pizza and a bong and boobies and other things. He said after he proposed and we were like walking back, he was like, posed in a shirt with titties on it. I was like, yeah, but it's one of your favorite shirts. Don't make sense. It's a pizza shop shirt. And yes. It has like a ghoul face on it. Look, can you see that in there? Oh, that was a pizza place that used to be on Capitol Hill. What was it called? Sizzle Pie. Oh, and they had vegan pizza. It was so good. It closed down. There's still one in Portland, but still. Do not support. Restaurants closing. So this minimalist color palette looks a little better. Is it still me to do this? Do I still like this cheek thing? I do. At least not for this. For my doodles, yes. spooky? I just don't know, guys. Oh, my wrist is starting to hurt a little bit. I don't know about the style. This feels important for some reason, even though it's just going on Instagram. Take a break, take a little stretch break when your wrist hurts. This is why I don't want to do decorations or like try too hard on my like invitations or whatever, because it feels like a lot of pressure, because it's like, you're a professional artist, you're both artists. It's gotta look good. And everybody's gotta be impressed and be like, yeah, I get it, they're a professional artist, they're so good. But I just wanna chill out about it. You know? You know what I mean? Alright, let's try to represent, put a pause on this and try to illustrate this background here, which is gonna be tricky, but we're gonna do it in multiple layers. Oh, my wrist is hurting. No good. You know what hurts when it hurts is this part right here. That's bad. It's like this whole part of my arm. Fine. We're doing fine. We can just keep drawing. Oh, that feels great. Keep drawing and not stop. What if I have to stop early? cubital tunnel? No, is that what this is? This muscle? It goes up outside the elbow? Oh my gosh, I'll have to research that. We do not support working to the point that you have bad wrist pain. Goodness gracious. Okay, well. Maybe I have to simplify it. Speed it up by simplifying. I'm gonna merge these two. Okay, I feel better after massaging it, but I'm gonna keep an eye on it and I will stop if it hurts too much. Thanks. All right, let's get a fun anchor so we can start to actually do the line art that we want. Let's rest, buddy. I'm okay. I might stop a little early, but I genuinely do want to draw this. But maybe it won't come out good today. Aw, man, guys, I might have to stop. Each time I go back to it, I get the twinging in my arm, and I have to draw a lot more tomorrow. Oh, this tells me I need to be better about trying to schedule not drawing in the middle of stream day so that my arm isn't tired by the time it comes to this. I probably shouldn't play a video game because it would probably do the same thing. Would it? Wait, would it use the same muscles? You're not supposed to play on the computer when you do an AMA. Oops. Right now? Okay. AMA. Is that how you do that? Oh no, I hate this. I hate that it hurts. It's me anything. Why does your arm hurt? Because I've drawn all day. Did I draw yesterday? A little bit. What's your... Oh, this is fun! Okay, well maybe I can change the topic of this so people... somehow... How to change Twitch... I don't know, it doesn't matter. Okay, well this is great. Okay, what's your favorite piece you've done this year and also all time? Goodness. This year, maybe I can look on my, oh yeah, since it's not, I'll try to pull something up on my iPad. What have I made this year? So I've made a lot of these ghosts. Oh my gosh, I know the answer. I am so proud of the designs that I've done for Art Town. Like genuinely, I really think it's fun. I think the color palette's fun. I think the like little rainbow and the future is arty thing is fun. And I really love all the little guys. Well, these are good questions, Kayla. Thank you. I really love these little drawings that I did for the tears. I'm really proud of them. And I'm proud of this banner that I did. Actually, this is a good time to show. I went through a lot of, like, experiments. Here, I'll pull it up in Procreate. I had a whole like thing that I drew and then I hated how it came out. So here was the sketch first for Art Town. Just trying to get like the idea down. At first I had the idea of doing a little like pencil statue in the middle and it being in a garden. But mostly I was just trying to get like the, you know, the layout idea down. And then this was the draft that I made based on that drawing. And I, you know, worked really hard on it. I put a lot of little details into this. But in the end, I felt like it was too... I just felt like it wasn't reading very well, partially because it had so many colors. And so your eye kind of... Pumpkin's Cafe, yeah. So your eye kind of goes to the sides rather than the focus on the center, which with the Art Town in the middle. Yeah, Pumpkin's Cafe. And then this was supposed to be like a little art shop and then a little plant shop. But yeah, I felt like I couldn't get the like color balance right. And see, I feel like the Art Town in the middle just kind of like faded out. So yeah, cool to see the development. Thank you. So there's that, and then this is an example of I totally scrapped that one and restarted with this, trying to like pull it out and have it be one color, so have yellow the whole way across and then just blue for the people and just green for like any kind of plants. And that way the sign in the middle, the like welcome to our town, the future is arty, would stand out more clearly because that's high contrast with the black. It's the only place that there's black in the design, and it's the only place that has like the red and the little combo of the rainbow. And maybe I can, I don't know if I have the place that I did the sketches for that, because I scrapped this, the other one, and just did a, let's see, time lapse replay. Yeah, okay, so see, I scrapped it and did a Greco. Is that Ian? Hello! Wait, aren't you at a party? I scrapped it and started redesigning with thumbnails, which is a great way to design, right? So that I could quickly, look how scribbly, quickly get, like, overall ideas. Hi, Kayla's husband. Are you at a bar? Yeah, Ian, if you have any questions for me to talk to, let me know. My carpal is hurting. So you can see here, on Patreon, on certain points, it has a little like circle face that overlaps on the banner. So I decided to try to incorporate that into it. And that's how we came with the little rainbow like curving thing to try to incorporate it that way. See? And so then this was the sketch phase at the beginning, just seeing if it would work, right? Look, this is fun. You can see I was experimenting with adding like colors to it. And then I was like, nah, just leave it white. This is so fun. This is kind of funny to do like the time lapse and just, it's like a watch party of my process. Sped up. Yeah, so there you go. Experimented with a bunch of different things. And then, so at first it was gonna be like white in the middle, and then Zach suggested filling in the background so it looked more like continuous underneath. And what's this? Oh, don't worry about that. But yeah, that's the development for that. And I'm really proud of how it came out. I feel like there's like a lot of different ways to move these things around. I really like the like greeting card thing with it. And I have lots of ideas about how to like incorporate it in the into the Twitch here. And I think it's just fun theming. I'm really proud of all that. So thanks for asking there, Kayla. And then you asked, what's your favorite of all time? Oh, what was that? My favorite of all time. Wow, what a big question. Turning and looking at my prints over here. You know, it kind of comes and goes based on my mood. But if I were to choose, and often my favorite is like something that I made recently, because it changes so much. Favorite of all time. I mean, this is one of my favorites. This is my logo on Instagram, because I love how simple it is. It's still like spooky, and it's got a lot of the elements that I like to add, like the bold color palette. I love this one. That's one of my favorites. And I also think I really love my chair ghosts. Yeah, I like these. They've got the same like straightforward, simple energy that I think comes out very funny and also spooky and like artsy. I think these are two of my favorites. I'm also really proud of my more recent Inktober stuff. Oh yeah, I think those are three of my favorites. I like the very like simple and like sassy and clean designs, which I do not think is what the Art Town thing is. I could see myself reworking it later. It still feels a little, some parts, excuse me, feel a little unfinished to me, but it's getting there. And some of my other work, I can't share yet because it's secret client work, but this is my favorite of my personal work that I've done. Great question, Kayla, thank you. You love Seattle and the Pacific Northwest. How does that reflect in your work? Do you think Virginia is part of it too? Oh my god, wait. Can you see pumpkins sitting in the suitcase? Look at her. Wait, can you have a babe? Oh, and it has that vintage vibe. Yes, it does. Yeah, I'll hang that up at my wedding. So I do love Seattle. I think it is reflected in, I love to represent rain and like rainy scenes. I have like lots of things that have like water puddles. I also think this is obviously representing Seattle because of the bus stop. I love to take the bus in Seattle. I didn't take that in Virginia. So like this rainy bus stop vibe. I've done this multiple times. I don't think I have any more of this one, but I also did a drawing of a girl waiting at the bus stop next, and like a ghost is waiting next to her too. So I think public transit has definitely come into my art because of Seattle. Here's another, you know, just lots of like walking art. I like to illustrate people just like hanging out and walking, and I think that's influenced by Seattle. Or the more rain. Definitely influenced that way. I love these like puddles. Oh, here's another. More rain. I'm a rain artist. Yeah, so I think that's how it's impacted it. And let's see, Virginia. I don't know if Virginia, unless it's just my childhood and like my background, but my experience of Virginia was in the exurbs. So we were like halfway between two bigger cities, Richmond and DC. And we always, for like most of my childhood, lived out in the country by like the water. So I guess part of it is that thanks to how I grew up, where I grew up in Virginia, I've always lived like in nature, and because we were far from anything and my parents were too busy or didn't want to like drive us 20 minutes to go do something, a lot of our activities were just like playing outside in the like water, or like making things out of, you know, sticks and shit and just like running around outside, and that was just like the only thing we really had to do until I got into playing computer games with Neopets and then I spent less time outside. But also when I was in Virginia, that is where I think there's a big like trend in the South, it seems to be, of if you're not like mainstream culture, like the subculture is very like kind of grungy, nature-y, hippie-ish, if that makes sense. I don't see a lot of that here in the Pacific Northwest. It really felt like the subculture is like drum circles in the park, you know, or even people who like live outside all the time. We used to call them crust punks in Savannah. to the point that when I was in like late high school, early college, I went to a concert, what's it called, like a music festival called Floyd Fest in the mountains in Virginia, and that like blew my mind because it was like the most hippiest shit. I was like barefoot the entire time, and you know, you shower like outdoor showers and everybody like camps there, and it has like a definite like, it's like mixture of the more modern festival scene with like bluegrass and like this grungy, weird, hippie, like Virginia Southern hippie version of things that's like all mixed together. And so I think that influenced me as a person a little bit. And I used to like to draw plants and things more. Now I'm more into like monsters and such generally, and Halloween-y things. But when I'm into drawing plants, it's probably because of that kind of like hippie culture of the South that I think is there. So I think Seattle has definitely influenced me more, especially because I went to school in Georgia. So I haven't lived in Virginia, you know, for 10 years now. Because I was, you know, a couple states away for 4 years after that. Great question. This is fun. Do you feel more creative at a specific time of day, morning, afternoon, night? I feel creative. Okay, so my brain, when I wake up in the morning, is like, I like wake up instantly. It's kind of bad if I wake up at like 6 in the morning or 5 in the morning because it's hard for me to get back to sleep. I fall asleep so good. I like clonk out for the night. But then if I wake up early, immediately my mind starts like churning with ideas, or worries, or, you know, anxious thoughts. But at its best, it's churning with ideas. Lately, it's been churning with like plans for wedding. So I wake, you know, I'm like, oh, what time is it? 6 a.m. I wonder if I should wear, like, what would it look like if I wore a 70s dress, you know, to my wedding? And how would that fit with everything else? Okay, well, what about, like, a 1940s dress? Would I be able to dance in that? That's, like, what I do in the morning. So, I guess technically that's creative. But then, when I get up, if I get up and I'm like, I gotta harness this creative energy. I've tried this before. If I get up right away and go to try to like draw, it's horrible. So I like feel creative early in the morning when my mind like gets started, but I guess my like hand and brain aren't connected yet. So I think with the schedule that I've had lately, Zach goes to work at like early afternoon usually. And, often I got an email, got distracted. And what was I saying? I totally forgot. It's gone. Look. so Zach leaves at like 2, and, I have lately been waiting until he goes to work to like really start working in earnest. I might like do a little bit of work from like 10 or 11 till he leaves, or until lunchtime and he leaves. And so lately I've been working, you know, around 4 to now. I usually stop at like 8 when he gets back. That's why it's funny, talking to people who are making their dinner early, because lately Zach and I have been making dinner at like 9:30. Dude, would not recommend. But it's what we've been doing. Great question, Kayla. Thank you. Next question. What's your favorite medium to create in? Oh, favorite. I love digital. I love the versatility of working on Procreate on my iPad a lot. But you know I love Posca markers. I love the bright colors and the like richness of it, and the like specific widths of the markers. And I also like that it's kind of a challenge to control the marker sometimes, which requires a lot of like planning ahead of time. So I think that's my favorite one right now. Yeah, love digital though, especially because it lets me experiment with a lot of the like styles of line work and texture that I haven't been doing physically, but maybe I should. I also like to sketch if I'm like really stuck and really not sure what I want to, like how I want to start with a project. I like to use like paper and pencil. I like to use any kind of pencil, but especially the like Prismacolor Colorase, or Posca markers on like butcher paper or something, because you can't like undo like you have seen me do. Look, I see you, pumpkin. There she is. And yeah, it makes me like process through my ideas better, because you know, you have to just like roll with the mistakes and just like instead of starting over and over again. So that's a good material. If you ever find yourself getting stuck with digital because you can get so nitpicky, it's nice to like sketch it first, traditionally, and then move on to that. Oh, you're good, Victoria. You're drawing a crab. You can do whatever you want. Oh, pumpkin. You get settled, baby. Any fave artists that inspire you from the past or current? Well, right now, I am super inspired by animation like crazy. And let's see, what did I watch? So I watched Luca. Zach's parents just signed up for Disney Plus, so we've been watching a lot of the stuff that we haven't seen on Disney Plus. But the designs in Luca were so inspiring to me. So I guess it's just like Pixar animators, right? And yeah, that one was really inspiring. And oh, we just saw The Bad Guys from DreamWorks, and the designs in that, obsessed with. Like, I'm so inspired by I've been lately thinking like maybe I should get like a new life goal and maybe see if someday in my life I can work in animation, you know, maybe get my first animation job when I'm 45, you know, because it takes a lot of work to get into animation, and I'm starting from nothing, just art. And so I usually don't work towards something because it's hard to get over the like hump of feeling like you're bad at something. At least for me, it's hard to, you know, I like things that I can get really quickly, and animation seems like so far off, but maybe someday I'll get to do that. So yeah, animation, you know, and we did the Disney, or we did the master studies, and I did Disney master studies. Okay, goodbye. yeah, so animation's been the most. And I am always inspired by my friend and artist Marlo Daub. I feel like she has very similar art to me, and she's using it to design video games especially, and she's a great character designer. I think I've just been really into character design lately, which means I should try to learn more about it and practice it more. So, let's see. Also, I've been really liking an artist. His Instagram account is Bad Bucket, and here, I'll write it down. Don't know if it's probably very different from how my art seems, but so cool. And always super inspired by local Seattle illustrator Pam Wishbow. Pam's art is amazing and so cool. I think about it all the time when I draw. I'm like, how would Pam do this? Which is probably not a good practice. And finally, I'm looking at some art that I actually like have hanging up. Okay, I'm trying to remember this artist. Natalie. Oh, maybe she signed it. Yeah, Natalie Andrewson. Also is another of my favorites. Natalie Andrewson does, I'll grab. Does Rizzo prints of these very cool characters and little fantasy scenes. They're amazing. my taste and interest in art have changed so much from when I was first making art, but maybe not. Maybe you can still see the influence. This is Natalie Anderson. Look at that. So cute. Oh, you loved Luca? Turning Red was good, yes. Luca really extra, like, touched me for some reason. I think partially because the little girl character reminds me of myself and my art style. Someone texted me to said that character looks like my art style, and I was like, oh. great. Thank you, Kayla. Ian, do you make much art that's just for you, or do you find yourself thinking about how to monetize everything? Oh, goodness. Ian, do I find myself thinking about how to monetize everything? Yes. Holy shit, absolutely. Which can be really hard, but that's part of why this Wednesday thing has been so useful so far. And I don't know if it's enjoyable to watch. That's part of what I asked in the thing. It's possible that you guys would be more interested in watching me draw, like, finished regular drawings, but I've been enjoying using it as a prompt to get myself to, like, just practice simply with, like, something that I can't monetize or that I don't necessarily want to. I should monetize it more because I need to make more money. I haven't been making very much money the last 2 years, but hopefully, you know, that'll get better with time. But it is hard to, like, get myself to, like, monetize things or to just make art just for me, or not even just for practice. I find myself when I do make art that's just for me, it is, I think I deleted it, but it's like self-portraits. I do a lot of self-portraits when it's just for me, and that's stuff that I'm, like, usually, like, no one, you know, cares to see it. Oh, you guys want to see something funny? I made this after Zach and I, Zach proposed to me. There you go. A little special stuff. This is his grandma. This is, we called her to tell her we're getting married, and she was wrapped up like this. This is me as a child. This is Zach. One of my favorite pictures of him, and this is a great picture of me. Here you go. So I guess this, Ian, this is an example of art that's just for me. I'm not gonna monetize, and I'm probably not gonna post it on Instagram. But who knows? Maybe Instagram would love it. Probably not. Instagram hates everything nowadays. Yeah. I probably spent half an hour to 45 minutes making this just for myself. Just to make me laugh. There you go. But, also, I think I deleted it. The animation that I did a while ago, sometimes I do animations, to, like, help me process through feelings, or just to get myself to draw something, or I'll just draw, like, a self-portrait just to, like, get myself to, like, move my hand, you know? So I think that's an example of things that I draw just for myself. But I don't make a lot of, like, full and finished art. I also keep a planner, and I also use it kind of as a little bit of, like, a scrapbook, because I like to look back and, like, see what happened. Like, for example, so this is art that I make just for myself. That's my sister's dog. I was watching him for, you know, do some doodling for myself. This is cool. I love that. Look at that little frog. And so I use did this at the beginning of the year. I think this is a good example of the type of things that I draw just for me. Because it's just like little stuff that makes me laugh or that makes me remember what was going on. Or just a way to get myself to just draw in the moment. Kind of like my sketchbook. Let's see. Or I'll like draw out little things that I want to remember. Here's here's that. Or little drawings for myself. Hi, Pumpkin! Sorry to startle you. So yeah, it's a great example of art for myself. Thank you for asking. What do you dislike about the art world and what do you like best? Okay, well, I dislike the isolation of being an independent artist and the things that that brings with it, especially the lack of consistency in pay over the entire industry. In that, because we are all independent contractors, literally, a lot of us are kind of, or the some clients will compete to basically get the like cheapest artist sometimes, instead of there being, okay, basically, I wish there was a strong illustrators union, so that we could have like a like standard of pay that you're supposed to charge. So that clients would pay everybody fairly, because I think especially so many of us, I think most of us, it's like a universal story that at the beginning it's like, geez, I can't believe I charged that, you know? And that's just how a lot of the industry is built, and it's hard. Another aspect of being independent and isolated that way by being an independent artist is the lack of benefits. Super sucks. I wish I like, you know, I guess part of it is if I made enough, I could, you know, more comfortably pay for things like retirement or healthcare or anything, but there's like no like central pot to draw from, really. You know, there's no like employer kind of like supplementing that to your wage, and it means that a lot of your profits are extra undercut because, you know, even I like tend to, I say like this is how much that I pay myself, but then I should be taking out like how much I spend on healthcare every month, you know. Which is still relatively low because we have pretty good affordable healthcare, I guess, based on your income level in Washington. But you know, that's unfortunate, and it's unfortunate that like I am saving for retirement, but there's like nobody to like, you know, match my retirement, or like I don't get a pension. It's just like whatever I save for. So there's none of these, like it's all on the individual artist to structure that, which is then compounded when you have the thing we were talking about earlier of the undercutting of the prices and the like, yeah. it's just hard to make a living, and I think it's partially that like isolation that makes it hard to make it like a sustainable long-term living, which is a big bummer, because we're doing real work. Real hard work, real, you know, that's one thing I love about the Graphic Artist Guild handbook, which is, I guess, like, the closest we come to, like, some of the benefits of you could have of, like, a union or, like, a good employer. I don't know. But it's that it talks about artists like they are laborers, which we are, and it helps you, like, shift your mindset. Like, this is a workplace injury, right? And to, like, think about the common workplace injuries that people in the art field would commonly come up to so that you can prepare yourself just like you would or should at a safe and healthy other job. So, yeah. But what I like about best is sometimes it pays well if you can find it. Not often enough, but sometimes it's really satisfying to work with people that like pay very fairly and are like genuinely trusting of you as an artist and as a laborer and as a like craftsperson. It's like satisfying to start to get to the point or to start to find clients who are like, here's what I can pay you, and it's pretty good pay. And they don't want you to work more. Like, I've even had someone's like, we're taking 2 weeks off this Christmas and I hope you are too. And I was like, thank you. I should take time off. It's like, thanks for prompting me to stop working for at least a week, you know, at Christmas time. But also to be like, here's what we got. And then you like give it back and they're like, oh my God, it's perfect. As usual, you know, I've had some clients that like I've worked with a lot and they're always like, sounds good, I trust you. So, like, this is great. Excellent work, no notes, awesome. So, that is nice. It's nice to, I don't think that's necessarily a part specifically of the art world, but I like that there is a whole, just, like, industry there that you just have to find your, like, place in. And I don't think, I don't know if I've fully done that, but, like, I'm starting to see, like, oh, they're just like, there's like real money like moving around within this. You just have to like find how you fit into that. And then once you do, you feel respected most of the time and trusted, and I don't know, makes me feel like I'm good at it, which is great. That was a fun question. Thank you. You could have any superpower, what would it be? I would like to, I know this is a very like white person answer, but I would love to travel back in time, or forward in time, but especially back in time, because I've always wanted to. I'm so interested in just like everyday details, or just like I'm interested in trends and fashion and like objects and typography and design, and I'm just interested to see like what things looked like and what the like vibe is. And I say it's a white person thing because it was a more racist time and sexist, I guess. I am a white woman, but I just want to, I would just like to see things. Well, luckily it doesn't matter because I cannot travel back in time, so just a fun question. This has been great. Great suggestion, Kayla. I hope this is interesting to anybody that's watching now. And anybody that watches the video in the future. The video on demand. Hi. Hi, from the past. You're traveling back in time to see me now. I guess I'll do a last question from Ian. Thanks for letting me rest my arm, guys, again. Do you aspire to have a studio space outside your house, your own studio, or shared with a small group of artists? Or do you like the flexibility of working from home? Oh, I would love to have a studio space outside my house. Very much. I think there's a lot that I like from working from home. But I have been missing people. And missing having a separate space and missing having people around to, you know, bounce like ideas off of, but also to just be like, did I work enough today? You know, I feel like it's really hard to tell when you work full-time for yourself from home to be like, it constantly feels like I didn't do anything. And sometimes that's true. But a lot of times I did a lot, you know? And it's only when, like, I talk to Zach and I'm like, this is what I did today, you know, or someone else, or write it on Patreon, for example, that I'm like, wow, that was a lot. and I felt like I just, like, fucked around all day, you know? And I also, especially after the pandemic, realized that I really like to, like, be, I like to walk places and to, like, move to somewhere else. So ideally I would, like, love a place that I could walk to work. That would be great. I mean, possibly eventually I would love, you know, my dream used to be to have, like, a studio space that I could share with other people and have tools that I could share with other people. I don't know, like a risograph printer or other expensive art equipment. But now I'm not sure, you know, now I want to be an animator. So maybe I just want to work in an animation studio. Yeah, so I would like that, but I feel like the downside is, I mean, studios cost money, but a lot of, it seems to me, I could be wrong, but it seems to me like a lot of studio spaces are overpriced for kind of what they give you in return. Because there are places that are like art studios that are like, you can rent a studio space, but it's like hundreds of dollars. And then you also have to work in the shop, so you also have to labor and you're paying. I don't know. Seems sus. seems expensive. So I would probably rather find like an affordable place and split it evenly instead of trying to make... That's what it seems like a lot of studio spaces are trying to make money from artists. Too much money, you know. Not just to, like, cover the space. Not to, like, split it, but to, like, profit. Whoa, spicy. I know nothing. This is just the sense that I get. Yeah, so I would love to. The studio space can help with isolation. Mm-hmm. Also doing this helps a little bit. Because I know y'all are out there, but... seeing people in person helps too. Yeah. Well, that was fun. Guys, thank you for being understanding about having to rest my arm. And I will try in the future to be better about not drawing in the middle of the day that I have to stream so that my arm is tired by the day. Yeah. Thank you, Kayla, for the prompt and the questions. And I guess... let's see, did anybody share any art? I don't think so. Community studio. Kayla did! Victoria, if you want to snap a pic, you're welcome to, or to share. Or we can just admire Kayla's. Kayla, hell yeah! Did a sketchbook stream. Sketchbook spread. Sketchbook spread during stream tonight. Your random photos from your saved folder on Instagram. Some of them you like, others not so much. Oh, look at this. Look at this eagle. Cute. She bold and she bald. Yeah, hell yeah. Cute. A little snail. This will be your tattoo, Kayla. Very cute. Oh, look, you referenced, you said where you got the pictures from. A beautiful pup. Nice daffodils. Those are good. I mean, the whole thing's good, but I love the daffodils here. Little puffins. Cutie. cutie. A wonky bear. What's that, pumpkin? Is it your dinner time? Pumpkin's telling me. Stop streaming. And cute. Stop it. No more. Pumpkin is protesting. Hi, Cody. Hello, how's it going? I'm about to head out. Dream is almost over, but thank you for coming to say hello. How have your streams been before I go? Aw, yeah. I also had to stop partway through because I started to get wrist pain or arm pain. Kayla correctly told me to stop drawing if my arm was hurting. So we've been doing an AMA since. Now we're admiring the art that my Art Town residents made. Thank you for the close-up of this, Kayla. This is extremely good. Look at these eyes. Is this a tongue? No, wait, no, it's the scarf, I see. I thought it was the tongue. So fancy, this one. I love these eyes. Very nice. Thank you for sharing that. I'm glad you got to do some drawing. A little peek of the crab from Victoria. Oh my goodness, this is beautiful. Wow, great job with these. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different colors. That is working really well together. Oh my goodness, lovely. Wow, and you know I love this color blue. This is one of my favorite colors. These are so good. Are you selling these? I hope you're making these. And because you have a shop, right? You shared you opened a shop last year? This year? I think last year. Because you should totally, these are great. People would eat these up. I like the little side, little sneaky side. I do, I haven't listed anything. Oh, I see, you should just sell these for sure. I bet they would also sell well if you go to markets of any sort. People love this kind of thing. That's awesome, guys. Thank you for sharing. And thank you for your understanding partway through the stream. Yeah, I'll be more careful, but I'm hoping to do markets once my kids can get vaccinated. Oh, yes. That makes sense. You should wait for that. I hope they can soon. Fingers crossed. Yes. So, thanks for coming. Next week, we're having another stream, same time, 11 a.m. to 12 Pacific Standard Time, and 6 to 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. This stream is sponsored by my Art Town residents, my patrons. Thank you for support, for paying me to take a day each week to just do some drawing and experiment and fail sometimes and to learn new things. If anybody here would like to become an Art Town resident, it's at patreon.com/regonia. There should be a link in my Twitch description, but that's where we do the private Discord and it's a good time. And everybody there is super nice and sometimes they tell me to take a break when my arm is hurting when I'm drawing. But yeah, check it out there, or you can check me out on Instagram at @regonia_ or on Twitter. And that's all. That's all the spots, and here on Twitch. I also have a shop, etsy.com/regonia, where I sell a bunch of art prints. Here's one, for example. They're all next to me. But yeah, I'll see you guys next week. And arm won't hurt. Okay, goodbye. Wait, oh, I have to set up the indexing. Bye, guys. Have a nice night. It's been really fun. See you later.
Thank you.